Good evening, saints of God. We greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and we thank him for blessing us to see another Wednesday evening here at Isha Ruth, the Missionary Baptist Church, located in Picayune, Mississippi. My name is Pastor Brian K. Dees, and on behalf of all of the saints that labor here in this vineyard, that labor together and do the work of the Lord and the ministry of the Lord, we're just happy to be here one more Wednesday evening to give you a word from the Lord. Before I give you this brief teaching, I want to let you know that we are continually praying for you, praying one for another, praying for the Lord to keep us, to help us, to strengthen us, to strengthen ourselves in him, to encourage ourselves in him, that no matter what, to know that God is able. We are praying also tonight for, I want to make mention of Sister Melina Mason, the loss of her husband. We have a grieving wife, a blessed sister of this ministry, children that are grieving, a family that is grieving over the loss of her husband, and a father and a loved one, and this church is grieving. And so we are praying for them and asking you to pray for them and to pray with them also, that God would encourage their hearts as we prepare to do our best to show them loving kindness, to give her husband a blessed home going. And so we're thankful tonight. I ask you to think of it this way. Is there a word from the Lord? Yes, there is a word from the Lord. If you have your Bibles, turn with me to the first book of John. And we're going to begin reading at chapter number 4 and read from verse number 4, verse number 1 down through verse number 4. And there glean the message, the teaching for tonight. 1 John chapter number 4, verses 1 through 4, and it reads, "Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. Hereby know ye the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesseth that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is of God. And every spirit that confesses not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is not of God. And this is that spirit of Antichrist, whereof ye may have heard that it should come, and even now already is in the world. In verse number 4, ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world." And we use for a thought tonight for this lesson that God is greater. God is greater. John, the Apostle John, this is the first of his epistles that are referred to as the Johannine letters that were written to the saints of God to warn them of false teaching and false prophets and of an antichrist, those that would come acting like they were representatives of God, but really were false prophets, were false teachers, were wolves in sheep's clothing, trying to deceive the children of God. And John wrote this intimate, what I would call an intimate personal letter, where he refers to us as little children. Another father would warn his children, listen, beware of these certain traps. There are things that the world, that the devil is going to set aside, especially for you, to get you caught up in, to entangle you in a snare, to confuse you, to cause you to doubt who God really is. And John is warning the saints of God, and that is what God is doing for us tonight, warning us, little children, try the spirits, whether they be of God, because the devil, you know, he's a spirit, he's a contrary spirit, he's an evil spirit, and he walks around trying to portray himself as a child of God. But if you try and you discern anything contrary about him, you will know that he is not real. And that is what John is encouraging us, the children of God, to do tonight. try the spirits, whether they be of God, there's going to be something about the devil. And I've heard it said before, the devil can sing in the choir, the devil can pray, the devil can give, the devil can serve in positions of leadership. The devil can do all of these things, but he cannot live holy. H-O-L-Y. That is one thing about the devil. He cannot live holy. It's going to be something that is going to portray itself to let us know that this person is not of God. They are a fake. They are a phony. They are false teachers. They are false prophets. And so I'm encouraging us tonight to listen as little children, to go on our knees and pray, to study our word, to call on the name of the Lord and help and ask him to help us to give us a spirit of discernment, one of the gifts of the spirits that will allow us to discern things that are not right in our spirit, to let us know something is not right with what I'm hearing. Something is not right about what I am seeing, about what I am feeling. And the God we serve will let us know this is not of God. And he gives us this blessed assurance. He says greater. That's why we use the thought for tonight. Greater. God is greater. He says, in spite of the world we're living in spite of trying times, in spite of false teachings, false prophets, false things that are not of God, John, let us, the little children, as little children, understand tonight. He says, greater is he that is in you. In other words, God is greater in us. He says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. God is greater. Don't even worry about it. The devil is no match for God Almighty. And I encourage us tonight to know that God is greater. When you feel weak in your spirit, know that God is greater. When you feel that you are overwhelmed with circumstance in your life, know that God is greater. When you feel that you need clarity and understanding about something that is going on in your personal life, in your walk with God, in your church, in your home, in your community, in your workplace, wherever you may be, know that God is greater. And he will give you the insight to know if you just pray and ask him, Lord, let me see, show me what I need to see to let me know if this is of you or is it of the devil. And he will let you know, because greater is he that is in us. God is greater than us, the children of God, than he that is in the world. I want us to know tonight that God loves you, and because he's greater, and because that there's no weapon formed against us that's going to prosper, and because we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us, and because we are more than overcomers. In other words, greater. God is greater. And because Jesus is the all-time champion of the world, because he fought the good fight of faith, because he kept the faith, and we're encouraged to do the same thing, and we can do it because greater is he that's in us than he that is in the world. God is greater. I pray tonight that God has given you something from the word to help you to make it on through the next days to come. And until we see each other again, saints of God, I love you in Jesus' name, praying for you, ask you to pray for me. We pray one for another in Jesus' name. Until the next time, God bless you. Amen.